All right. Are we live in person? It always seems to go live before you expect it to. It looks like I am live. I got three people already. Yeehaw. Let's not do it like that. Who's checking in? Say hello. All right, Dustin Wartenberger's in first. Yeah, hey, what's up? Justin, my man. All right, about to get muted. Good times, I love it. All right, Mark, Kyle Kelly. All right, Kyle, joining in. It's good times. Quarantine people all hopping in there. Facebook live and all over the place. Trying to keep it interesting, you know? It's craziness, as it were. Got my little setup going on. Trying to bring you guys something interesting, different. Drum lessons for free, online, on Facebook. Who would have thought? You know, maybe down the road, somebody will get to do some drum lessons in person again, you know, see how it goes. James Casper. Jimmy, what's up, man? We were just watching some Van Halen. I was thinking of you last night. I was watching this Van Halen live in Dallas. Awesome. What an awesome show. It's like an hour and a half on YouTube. They're outside at a park. It's really great. So, Dustin, to answer your question, I will let you know that today we're going to play some Breaking Benjamin. So, as long as the YouTube lords of copyright will let me get through the whole song, I'm going to, work on that tune for you guys and then kind of break it down and show you what it's all about. So, you know, there's a lot of cool stuff going on in that tune. The name of the drummer from Breaking Benjamin at the time was Jeremy Hummel, very good player with a lot of cool ideas. In that genre of like kind of hard rock, not really new metal per se, but like, you know, that, kind of crazy, hard rock. I love Breaking Benjamin. From the first record up till now, they're always, especially the drummers, all the guys that have been the drummers. Jeremy Hummel is a great drummer. Chad Zaliga is another great drummer, whom I met on the Rock Legends cruise when he was with Black Star Riders. Super cool guy and an amazing player. With his crazy ride cymbal all the way up here, like Dave Weckl action, but like in space. He's got this ride cymbal with a big bell and he's like, clang! You know, it's awesome. And the third drummer, the guy who's in the band now, is a dude named Sean Foist, who is also equally as talented. So if you've listened to the last couple of Breaking Benjamin records after they sort of reemerged, you know, whatever it was, 5 or 6 years ago, Sean has been in the band for a while now and he is killing it. So, all players that brought interesting little tidbits to the band. Similar in a lot of their stylist ways of playing, but all have those little cool, like, lots of rhythmical stuff in the kick drums, bell sounds and splashes, cymbals, things of that nature. So a lot of different things going on. You met Jeremy at Modern Drummer Festival. Excellent. Devin Machado, what's up, man? Hope you're doing well. Killing it out there. I see your posts on Facebook sometimes. You know, looks like you're kicking it in the Verizon biz, selling some cell phones and whatnot. That's great, man. Keep at it. I hope you're still doing the DJ thing. I mean, obviously not right now, but, in general. All right. Got a few people. Did I miss any questions? I'm checking back real quick. See if anybody else. All right, I think we're good. I think I covered everybody so far. So here's the thing. So this song I'm going to play is called So Cold. It's off the first Breaking Benjamin record, I think. Or maybe the second record? First or second record, somewhere way back. It's like 10 years old now. But it's a cool tune. So look for, some of the things I talked about, some of the rhythmical kick drum parts and some things like that. And hopefully I'll be able to play all the way through. Like I said, there is going to be a copyright on this thing. As immediately after I'm done, the Facebook is going to try to shut it down. So I'm recording this, and then I'm going to upload it on YouTube after the fact. And I'll post that link later So if anybody catches this part of the video and goes, well, what happened to the audio or the music? You can always go to my YouTube page after the fact. I'll post the link and you guys can check out the playthrough of the song at that point. All right, so that's kind of the deal with that, and I hope everything's good. So, it is now 7 o'clock. As I like to say, it's time to rock. All right, so let me make sure I got some good volume here. Get everything rocking. Here's some Breaking Benjamin for you. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. All right, so there it is, some Breaking Benjamin for you guys. Cool. Just making sure nothing's happening over here. So there we go. Let's take a look and see what's going on. So again, like I said, real quick, this is probably gonna get muted at some point. So if you guys are checking in later, I'm probably gonna delete this and then I'm gonna re-upload it to YouTube. So visit me on YouTube, check it out over there. At my Bandstand Live Rock Academy page on YouTube. Like I said, I'll post the link for you. But that's kind of the deal as far as this goes. There's a copyright thing with Facebook. They haven't worked it out yet. YouTube has figured out that they can put advertisements in front of videos and make money enough to pay off the publishing royalties for the songs. So that's why they don't bust people for putting stuff up there, but you can't monetize that video. So you can't make any money off of somebody else's music, which is cool, you know, in their way they got it figured out. Facebook hasn't quite figured it out yet. I guarantee at some point soon, they're gonna do that. And they're gonna figure out a way to put advertisements on every live stream and every video you watch on Facebook. And it's gonna kind of suck at first until you get used to it. And like you do on YouTube, everyone's used to it. All right, so let's see. Who's in? It's all right, Lauren. Yes, it is. Michael, man, hey, we didn't really meet, but I saw you sing at Justin Pacey's thing last summer at Bernie's. Awesome job, man. Ripped it. This guy Michael's an amazing singer. I don't want to blow the spelling of your pronouncement of your last name, but it's like Borgenfinkel. Dude's an awesome singer. Killer, man. Great job. I was blown away. I was like, man, this guy is killing it. So let's see. Cool. So hello, people saying hi. Steve Kanzioka, hey, how are you, man? It's been a long time. Fritz checking in. My man Fritz and his brother, those guys do a crazy lighting stuff. Boston Event Lighting Company, really cool. They did lights for the Gary Hoey DVD a few years back. That was super cool. They did a killer job with that. Yeah. Ron Knatzer, how are you doing, brother? Good to see you. Thank you. Chad. Good to see you. Hope you're doing well out there. It's finally starting to thaw out in good old Michigan in the Detroit. So let's get into it. I'm going to talk about some stuff as far as the tune goes. So kind of out of the gate, you know, he's got this kind of mellow sort of ride cymbal part. Pretty standard groove for most players, except the bass drum part is sort of minimal. So to check that out, you know, it's going to sound like this right out of the gate. Okay, so that's the first groove, pretty straight up, right out of the gate. Now, the thing you gotta remember about a lot of these dudes from these types of bands is that the challenge to a lot of it is all the parts are different. There's no one part that's always the same. The fills are different, there's a little bit of changes. The grooves are slightly different in each section. So that part only lasts for 4 bars and then it goes away, okay? And then right out of the gate, we're on to the crash cymbal part. And you know, we're doing this kind of heavy intro before the verse comes in. So the verse part is, well, I like the part right before the verse. Let's check that out. So the fill that happens out of the intro section into the verse is gonna be this. Right, so you got that double flam. Blah, blah, gush, gush, gush. Now you're into this really cool linear pattern in the verse section. I've got a snare drum over here that is an extra side snare that has the snares turned off. So, turn the snares off and you get this kind of like, you know, Tommy kind of sound, right? Like a bongo almost. So the basics of this is you got to get this linear pattern happening. So again, I love linear patterns, and a lot of times to get them comfortable, the trick is to just spend time with a linear pattern without any of the other stuff and just get it under your hands, okay? So we're gonna spend some time working on this initial part, okay? So right out of the gate, the first part is just two toms. And from there, we're gonna play the snare drum pattern, which is on the other drum, but I'm gonna play it on the main drum for now. So you're gonna have three snare notes, okay? First one being an accent, and then three snare notes and a kick like this. Okay, so that's the first part of the linear pattern. And from there, you're going to go into, it's actually leads right into another kick. So you're going to want to learn the first two beats of this section, and you're going to get this. Okay, so that's right, left, right, kick, kick, right, left, and then kick, okay? So that'll kind of give you the first chunk, you know, of that linear pattern. And then the last part is going to be two snares, an open hi-hat, and a kick drum. That's the last part of the linear pattern. So it's going to be like this, right? We're going to get. Okay, so if we put all three of those beats together, we're skipping the first beat. We're just playing two, three, and four now. So it's going to be like this. Okay, so you've got right, left, right, kick, kick, right, left, kick, and then right, left, right on the hi-hat, kick. Okay, so again, like this. I'm going to add the first two notes with the toms. It's going to go like this. Blew it. Okay. So that's the main thing. Let me play that one more time. Keep putting the hi-hat part too soon. Either way, so let's get into the rest of it. So what's going to happen here is we got to add some flams, some rudiments. We got a flam on the right hand. One of the things that makes this cool is the accents, and it also helps you to play the pattern a little bit easier. So the right hand accents push the rhythm along a little bit. All right, so we've got. We're gonna accent the first of each group that it starts. Okay, so you're gonna go. Right, so make sure that you're accenting, you know, each grouping after the bass drum, and that'll be helpful. All right, so again, the whole thing. Now, if you only got the one drum, just turn your snares off and play it right in front of you. So now you got. Go back into the toms each time, there's gonna be a kick. So that's the main verse. Now there's a little lick that he does out of the main verse back into the sort of pre-chorus of the song, all right? And we're gonna do this thing. So we're gonna go, you know, we're at the, you know, doing the thing. Oh. Flam on the snare, left, right, kick. Okay? Brat, do, do, do. And then another snare with the left hand. Okay, then we're into some kind of rocking cool beats here. We got a bunch of different bass drum notes. You gotta learn some of the rhythmical chug-chug of the guitar parts. That second one right there goes right along with the guitar. Jo-jo, jo-ga, jo-jo, jo-jo, ga-ga-ga. So, you're comfortable with that one. You know, that's gonna be helpful. The next measure has a little bit of an extra snare part in it. So we're gonna go. So that's going to be some 2/32nd notes right at the end of that measure. Dig-a-dash, dig-a-dash, okay? So work on that. This is the third measure into that section right there. And then we've got this basically the same bass drum pattern. Only difference being is that he changes it up a little bit, crash, crash at the end, okay? So let's see what else we got going on here. Devin, that's correct. It is very much the taking a dump lick, pretty close. So. And to answer your other question, yes, still at Bandstand Live down in the Ware. Drop by and see me sometime, okay? So, moving on from there, we got, he does that same figure with the 32nd notes again. Okay, so if you're playing that normal right-handed way, you got. Check out that last part, that's a fun little bit to add, okay? Basically the same figure again happens at the end of this particular section, but he does four notes as 32nd notes at the end, so it's gonna be this. You got right hand on the first rack, and then three snares consecutive after that. And from there, we're going to the crash part, okay? You also got to work this little fill into the crash part because there's an extra snare drum right out of the gate. Okay, so you got to work that connection from the fill into the next groove on the crash. And then we got that same thing. And then we're back into. Does that for a bit. This next chunk is very similar to the first chunk after it comes back into the hi-hat again. So there's not too much to worry about there. He does do one set of a flam with three crashes. So you're gonna go. In the last chunk of that section, it goes back to the crash instead of staying on the hi-hat like it does the first time. So that's something to look out for. And there's a lick that he does right at the end of this crash section, which is going to be this. And again, this is the same shape as what Devin mentioned, the taking a dump part. But it is, you know, in 32nd notes. So it's just straight, even dugga da umbra, right? So it's not in the round shape of a single stroke four when you get taking a dump, right? That the kiss, taking a dump, I'm taking a dump, I'm gone, right? You don't want to do that. So just four notes, right, left, right, kick, and then back to the flam on the snare, and then one more kick. So it slows down. Okay. Daga dum brat bum. So that last note's slower. Okay. So we stay on the crash cymbal. Actually, we're going to go to the China cymbal for this section. This is kind of like the breakdown section on the China. It was a popular thing to do for a while. It's still popular, actually. A lot of guys still do it. It's a cool effect. It gives it that kind of open space. You know, instead of using a hi-hat or a crash, you go to the China. Just happens to be like what a lot of new metal guys refer to as the breakdown. So we got this cool bass drum pattern that goes along with that. The trick to that part is just to get all of those syncopated rhythms with your right foot without having the eighth note pattern happening on either a hi-hat, crash cymbal, or a China in this case. So we're playing quarter notes. So we got. So one and a two. There's a lot of space around that one hi-hat note. So you really got to be able to subdivide internally to keep those bass drum notes from getting jammed together, okay? So you'd be thinking the 16th notes the whole time while you've got that spacing, you know, happening with the right hand playing a quarter note, the downbeat, and everything's working off of it. So that can be challenging. Make sure that you spend some time developing those quarter note grooves with bass drum patterns underneath it. Make sure you work through a lot of the variables that happen. The China. And hey, this is a PG establishment here. Thanks, dude. Cool. So next section of the song goes back to the crash cymbal for a second. Same beat as the China part, but then you got eighth notes. So if you're having a trouble with the China part, you can always try it with the eighth notes. And then it's cool, he does a little fill right here, which is 32nd notes, four snares, and four kicks. So that's a cool little lick, but it starts on the one, so you gotta be ready for that, okay? So you gotta work on the phrase that happens prior to it, and then work your way into that particular fill. So it's right on the downbeat. It's a one and a two, right? Okay, comes in right away. Now he's got that same lick that we played from the previous section with the four notes, meaning right, left, right, kick. That happens again. So you're good on that one. Moving forth from there, then we've got a bunch of stuff happening. Going back to the hi-hat part, it's basically the same groove that we played in the earlier two sections of the song on the hi-hat, which would be this. That same riff that goes gung 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 gung, right? It has that same kind of chunky guitar part, which once you've learned it, that's like the one constant in the song. You get that like a few times. You can play it every time it comes around. It's always the same. Whereas the other parts are little variables each time. So this section here is similar in most ways to the previous time that it happens in the song, except for it goes into like a break at the end where there's a stop. So we just got to learn a basic fill. Now it's the same fill that we did with some of these other ones, except there's a flam on the first note, and it's only 16th notes. It's going to be this. So it's just half the speed of the other one that was. Okay, so it's easy to check out. And then you're going to stop right on downbeat of one for one whole measure, rest for another measure. There's a little 16th note to come in on the hi-hat, right? You got. Joel. Michelle, your question is, are you doing Skype lessons? And the answer is yes, I most certainly am. So if you ever want to get together and do a Skype lesson, I'd be more than happy to hook you up. All right? Shane, Hell Rizzer in the house. Good to see you, man. Greg Golden, kicking it. So, back to the Derek Lee. I was thinking about you the other day, man. I was watching a Mike Johnston video, and he had his Groove Freedom app out. And I was like, I know the man behind that. The man. Brian Dixie, what's up, man? Good to see you. So getting to the end of that section, right? 16th notes on the hi-hat. Opens up a little bit at the end. And then we got this cool fill, which goes. Okay, it's a syncopated rhythm. Two snares and a kick. And then two kicks. So it's snare, snare, kick, kick, snare, snare, kick, kick, snare, right? It's a cool fill. And then at the end, we got a little layered part that goes. Okay, now we're at like the outro of the song. Go back to the crash cymbal, but the beat is different. It's new here. So there's some differences that you want. I missed a few over here. I missed my girl Trish saying hi. Hey Trish, how are you? I'm so sorry that I missed you. Joel, yes, please do, man. Send me your information. I'd be happy to hook it up and we can make something happen. Matt Little in the house, checking it out. You wanna learn some drums, man? Getting bored with the guitar? Be good to learn some drums, dude. You can write your own demos and thing. I know Kyle plays a little bit of drums. You should get in on playing the drums too. And you guys could have drum wars with Ethan. You have three drum kits on stage. Instead of, Godsmack having two drum kits, you can have three drum kits on stage. They're all gonna move around. It's gonna be sick. I can see it, right? One's gonna do the Tommy Lee thing, and then the other ones are gonna move like this. You just combine all the ideas. Take Tommy's idea and the Godsmack idea and just put it all in one thing. It'll be cool. Trust me. It'll be the best thing ever. Fire and flames. Loud drums. Can't go wrong. Yeah, so the outro of the song, right? So we got... So, banging on that crash cymbal, bunch of kick drum patterns, got to work through all those. It takes a little bit of doing. And then the last chunk of the song, is this is the only time this occurs, is he's got this like crash part that kind of hits on the downbeat and then on the and. So we got this thing that goes... Okay, so you got to work on that part. It's probably, you know, one of the easier parts of the song is right at the end there. He does do another one of those little 30-second note skips at the second one. Okay, and then there's that sort of orchestrated part at the end. Dun, ga, dun, dun. All right, and that's the end of the tune. So, that's the basics of that. And can anybody tell me if the original part has been muted yet or not? I don't know. Maybe it has by now. Maybe it hasn't. If it's still going, then... Yes. Joe, you asked me a question about some gear. This China cymbal on the right here that I'm playing is a 16-inch Oriental China Trash from Zildjian. So... I know it's a little dark in the corner over there, but you know, you can't quite see it under this crash. But yeah, it's a 16-inch Oriental China Trash, which I dig the sound of it a lot. when I played drums, there wasn't a double bass pedal in existence. Well, you know, some guys didn't need the double pedal, like John Bonham didn't need the double pedal. You know what I mean? He had just a quick right foot, got it rocking. So, you know. You know, sometimes that's all it takes, you know. One foot, get the triplet thing going. You know, there's a whole technique world that, you know, develops around getting that double thing. There's a couple of schools of thought in terms of the approach to getting the double thing. I probably spent more time in lessons over the years teaching that technique than any other. Everyone now always asks me, how do you get the fast doubles, you know, the bounce doubles with the foot, the double stroke, the heel toe. It's one of the, you know, the most popular things that guys talk about, you know. So let's see if I switch this real quick. What does it look like? Which one did I just do? I'll make sure that that's, yeah, so. If you guys are looking at that, right, you can see this. You see my right foot here, heel up, heel down. When they talk about heel toe, you're not actually talking about playing with your heel on the pedal. That would be stupid. So just don't fall for that trap on the internet. The heel, for me, actually hits the ground behind the pedal. So there's a little bit of a skip and a bounce that happens from the first note where the pedal swings, and then my foot moves forward to play two notes. So I start in the up position, sort of flat, goes down, and when I strike from the back, I actually kind of skip off the front. I get one note, and then the second note comes in. Dustin mentions the slide technique. That's another approach that a lot of guys use where they play. Sliding the foot forward across the pedal, kind of skipping it across, almost like you're skipping rocks across water, that you kind of slide your foot in. That one never really worked great for me, so I always went for the heel-toe method, which is the bounce, you know, from the back to the front. So, just see that in the corner. If you want to look down there, you'll see my drum cam, foot cam in the corner. But yeah, so the bounce technique from the heel to the toe is what we use to create that sound. And guys like John Bonham were masters of it, you know, using that stuff in songs like Good Times, Bad Times. nonsense like that. So, yeah, it's kind of, you know, it's a lot of fun to use it. You can use it in up-tempo songs when you're playing, you know, metal stuff. Like if you're like an old school Metallica and you want to play, you know, some of that kind of thrash metal-y kind of things, it works good for that. Works good for any of that triplet kind of thing that I was just doing there. You know, so it's fun. Let's see. What else we got here? Yes. As Dustin, as I tell everyone that of my students, anything you needed to know about playing rock drums, you can learn from John Bonham. You know, that's the start. And then, of course, it develops from there. Hey, Scott, RDG in the house. We got Scott Schubert, one of my old school, Greg Robidoux in the house. We got a bunch of people checking in. That's cool. But RDG from San Diego, great guitar player, instrumental rock thing, and also fellow streamer, trying to get his stream game happening. So, you know, get it rocking. But yeah, John Bonham, man, is the basis of all rock drumming. Just bar none. It's just the easiest way to go. From there, I mean, there's tons of other drummers that are great. Don't get me wrong. But that's like a good encapsulating thing, not only because he played good rock drums, but he played interesting rock drums. So he made it so that you were learning rhythms and different kinds of things that were not just standard rhythms and standard, you know, backbeats and real straight kind of stuff. You know, a lot of his blues and jazz influence came into his playing, but he played it with an aggressiveness that wasn't really as, you know, well known at the time. So it was kind of cool to take some of these other feels and really put like a stiff edge to them. Like, I mean, he just played with, you know, ferociousness that was like unseen for a lot of drummers. So that's kind of the deal, you know, with the Bonham thing. You got to love it. You know, last week I did some Neil Peart, Rush stuff, which I'm still to this day, you know, hoping one of these days I'm going to do a take of that song Subdivisions and I'm going to get it right. You know, it's a challenge, man. It's a lot to remember. So, you know, it's all good. And I hope you guys are doing well. That's about it for me as far as the timing goes. I know I got some other friends of mine that are streaming tonight. Justin Pacey is going to be on YouTube. So, you know, again, I mentioned earlier, you know, about some of the issues with Facebook streaming live as far as playing music goes. If you're playing, you know, someone else's tunes, like doing cover songs, they're going to mute you. Whereas, so in the future, you're going to see me do some Facebook Live, and you're also going to see me do some YouTube stuff. And I'll let you know as it goes which one I'm going to do. If I'm doing event stuff, I can get away with it because I have the rights to the songs and I can, you know, no one's going to bust me for that. But if it's anything current, like the Breaking Benjamin thing, you know, it's really hard to get around their copyright. So I'll just do it on YouTube and let everybody know, hey, join me on YouTube. So, you know, when that happens, you guys will know that we're over on YouTube for the night. And if you feel like dropping in, you can. If not, then, you know, catch you the next time. New event stuff on the way, but not until June at this point. It's a new track coming out from event in June where we're going to release with a cool lyric video. Working on some stuff here in the studio as well in the meantime. And so I'll be back for more lessons. Tell your friends, whoever wants to study drums with me on Friday nights, you know, it's a good time. So, you know, we have fun. And I'm going to keep playing tunes and showing you how to do them. And in the meantime, I hope you guys are well and be safe out there. Hope we're getting to the end of this thing. I know there's some, it's pretty scary in concert land, man. It's like we had some shows, you know, planned that I was going to go see with my wife this summer. They're looking like they're all in the crapper. So it's not good, but it is what it is. They will happen again. It will return. Things will get better. And so thank you guys, and I will catch you all soon. Again, check out my buddy Justin Pacey. He's going to rip through some Soundgarden stuff a little bit later and kill it. So he's got his setups all fresh and good, buddy. All right. So again, thank you guys for coming in. Check me out on Instagram as well. My YouTube page, Bandstand Live Rock Academy on YouTube. I'll post some links later, and you guys can check it out. And talk to you soon. All right. Have a good night. Peace out, everybody. Thank you.